What's good? It's the one and only, but what do I know? Boxing coming back at y'all with another one, man. So we got Jaime Munguia in the news. Bruh, I am loving what I am seeing from Jaime Munguia. You know why? Because guess what? Jaime Munguia is in talks with Ronald Gavril for a fight in December. Yes, no, not December of 2025, but December of 2024. All right? This man has not even fought a week ago. And is already in talks with other fights and looks to be continuing his deal with Top Rank ESPN. Like, man, bro, oh my, listen, a lot of these fighters can take notes. You know why? Because guess what? We've already forgotten. I'm not going to say we've forgotten, but that Canelo Alvarez loss means nothing, absolutely nothing now. You know why? Because this man has fought three times this year. I tell people all the time, bro, the reason why these fighters' loss is more significant because these fighters are only fighting once every 15 months. So a loss holds more value because you have to sit on that loss longer. But when you do like what Jaime Munguia is doing, fighting in January, then fighting in May, he lost in May, he already fought in September, now he's talking about fighting in December, that loss now becomes irrelevant because why? You're staying active. That is why a loss is irrelevant, because a loss no longer means anything. If fighters stay active, you don't have to worry about that Floyd Mayweather holding on to your old syndrome, because you know why? We're going to forget about that. I'm not going to say we're not going to forget about that loss, but guess what? That loss now has no significant value because you have fought three times this year, and bro, we look to see you again two or three times next year. So that's why, bro, that's why I continue to say these fighters need to be active. Shout out to Jaime Munguia. Let's go ahead and get into the article. All right, so shout out to BoxingScene.com. It says, Jaime Munguia seeking Tijuana homecoming bout on December 14th. Responding forcefully from his Canelo Alvarez loss to post Friday night knockout victory, Jaime Munguia is reportedly moving towards taking another fight by the year's end, back home in Tijuana. Munguia, who has a record of 44-1 with 35 knockouts, has expressed interest in fighting former super middleweight title challenger Ronald Gavril, who has the record of 25-3 with 20 knockouts of Romania, December 14th at Tijuana's Caliente Stadium, according to reporters by ESPN.com, Salvador Rodriguez. That would be Jaime Munguia's fourth bout of 2014 after opening the year by stopping veteran former 160-pound title challenger John Ryder of England January in Phoenix. Munguia fought under the top-ranked promotional banner Friday after previously being contracted to the Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy promotion. And Top Rank chairman Bob Arum told Boxing Scene last week that he was planning on staging a series of fights in Mexico with Munguia serving as the linchpin attraction. Top Rank's president Todd DeBove told Boxing Scene Monday that his company Munguia and the fighter's Mexican promoter Fernando Beltran express joint appreciation over how the Top Rank debut show went, with Munguia capping a closely contested fight against previously unbeaten Canadian Eric Bunzinkajanga with the 10th round knockout. The Buff said that he was informed how Munguia wanted to stage a homecoming fight in December, adding Top Rank in his conversation, with Munguia's team extending their work relationship with more talks to follow. They communicated that they were very happy with the event, the attention he received, the shoulder programming, the socials, my team had an incredible experience with them, the Buff said. We love that they took satisfaction in our content, and it was a very positive experience. Another Top Rank official said flatly, the kid Munguia wants to be with us. So first of all, shout out to Phoenix, Arizona, because I'm telling y'all, man, we are doing the damn thing out here. Now, I wasn't born, nor was I raised in Phoenix. I moved out here in about 2018. But bro, ever since Eddie Hearn staged Chavez Jr. versus Danny Jacobs out here, dog, we've been getting a lot of fights out here. And I'm telling you, and the market is huge, especially if you're for the Mexican fan base, bro. Like, they're going to come out. They're going to show up and show out here in Arizona, bro. And especially when they have it at the Diamond Arena in Glendale and Westgate, bro. I'm telling y'all, y'all got to come out of there, bro. The vibe, the scenery, everything about it is beautiful, man. Just check it out when you get the chance. While Munguia was held up to some criticism for having some mid-round difficulties with Bazinkazanka, that tension made for a dramatic fight, and he was leading on all three scorecards at the time of the knockout. Arturo Gatti was flawed. Miguel Cotto got hit by right hands. The heavyweight fight we just saw between IBF champion Daniel Dubois and Anthony Joshua had flaws. But the give and take and Munguia's willingness to risk to land big punches is compelling. Actually, well, Cotto did have trouble with my right hands, but Miguel Cotto's kryptonite was a slick southpaw. But anyways, his willingness to land big punches is compelling and what makes the sport beautiful, DeBuff said. If you're going to take risks, you're going to get hit. I'd rather see that than a guy doing parades in the ring all night. This was more compelling TV, and you saw it in the arena with fans erupting multiple times. I was actually at that fight too, by the way. Aram said previously that he's enthused about taking fights to Mexico so his promotion can effectively capture the passion of the sport's richest fan base, conveying that generation's deep interest in a global television audience. In Gavril, Munguia will confront a now 38-year-old fighter who lost a split decision to then 20-year-old David Benavidez for the WBC super middleweight title in 2017 before Benavidez handed him a more convincing defeat by unanimous decision 5 months later. Yeah, but also, I, if I'm not mistaken, I believe Benavidez injured his hand in that fight too. But Gavril has fought more anonymous foes since, most recently getting in the ring on May 17th. All right, so, you know, let's talk about it, bro. It's just got to give a big shout out to Jaime Munguia. And I'm so proud of this dude, bro. I really am, man. I am so proud of this dude. Because these fighters are not, bro. Besides Canelo Alvarez, bro, what top fighter do you know is fighting four times or has fought four times in 1 year? Like, you know, it's just not happening anymore. And Jaime Munguia is doing it, and I'm really appreciating that, bro. Because, bro, guess what? We already want to see Jaime Munguia versus the likes of Caleb Plant, Edgar Berlanga, Diego Pacheco, any other top super middleweight we want to see him against aside from Canelo. I don't think anybody really cares to see that fight again. But hell, I'll even take him versus Trevor McCombie. Go ahead and make that fight happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro, listen. Jaime Munguia, this is what boxing is about. This is what I like to see. Because, and once again, bro, this dude is not. And I don't know if he's going back with De La Hoya because it looks like he wants to continue his work with ESPN. I don't care, bro. Go for it, bro. This is what it takes to be a top fighter. Now, no longer do we have to worry. Like, he doesn't even have to. Like, we ready to see him fight for a title again. Should Canelo vacate that title, we ready to see him fight for a title. You don't see anybody saying Jaime Munguia needs to retire or nothing like that. Why? Because Jaime Munguia got right back in the lab, bro. Jaime Munguia, bro, do you know that Jaime Munguia has fought three times since Jermall Charlo has last fought? Let that sink in for a second. Jaime Munguia has fought three times since Jermall Charlo has last fought. Jaime Munguia has fought, I want to say, four times since Errol Spence has last fought. Jaime Munguia had fought maybe four or five times since Danny Garcia last fought. And I know Danny Garcia just fought, you know, on the Canelo undercard, but I'm talking about before that Canelo fight. That's how active Jaime Munguia is. And, bro, that should tell you everything you need to know. We want to see how he might get. Now, if Jermall Charlo fights again and he loses, guess what? Everybody going to say he needs to retire. Why? Because he's not active. Jaime Munguia, it don't matter who he fought. If he would have lost in September, if he would have lost in May to Caleb Plant, he already bet we want to see him fight for a title. That man finna fight twice, four times this year. Let me know what you guys think. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. I told you. But what do I know?